Hello guys, welcome back to our channel, The Collector's Hub. Let's continue our survival drive in this strange place. If you like this kind of game and would like us to continue with it, give this video a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.
Thank you. There's a whole lot standing between where we are and the deep zone. Like another wall and the entire mid zone, for starters. It's not as simple as driving there. We can't control the instability any more than we can control the weather. At the height of limb R&D, thousands of us lived and worked here in the zone. So we built limb stabilizers to make certain sectors and roads a little more predictable than others. It was the only way we could operate as a live research compound despite the instability. And yes, the same technology that destabilized the landscape in the first place. Limb technology was always a double-edged sword from the beginning. We're going to put those stabilizers to work and clear you a path. The old observation towers surround the Sierra border have a map of the stabilizers in that sector. Mind swinging by and finding one? towers are locked up tight, but you could tighten up security protocols all day only for one disgruntled employee to program in his name for fun and mess it all up. Anyway, the overload code is 4735.
Find that stabilizer map and scan it for me.
Oh, boy. I was assigned to clean these towers out every time the guards rotated. And the things I saw... Let's just say that keeping a watch on Sierra day in and day out did not make for a good time. I didn't envy those guards one bit.
Near you. There you go. Found three sector stabilizers that'll do the job. They're not too far, so I've added the location to your route. The access road will lead you straight there once you're ready.
Thank you.
The woods there can be a bit of a maze. If you get lost, follow the pipes. The Limtech and those stabilizers ran so damn hot, only more Limtech could contain it from complete meltdown. It's my turn to give you an explanation about the mass hallucination event that Tobias and Francis were going on about. But don't worry, I won't be nearly as long-winded, because there honestly isn't much that we know about it. It happened on the morning of September 14th, 1961. My colleague, Dr. James Kay, was conducting experiments at a highly classified site in the Deep Zone. He was assisted by my husband, Dr. Alan Turner. At 0400, their experiment unleashed a gamma-ray surge that instantly killed both of them. The surge was an impossible amount of energy, orders of magnitude greater than any man-made source. It also triggered hallucinations in anyone awake within a 10-mile radius. It was a burst of widespread insanity, but only for a short moment.
You know, 30 seconds of hallucinations sure didn't feel short when I was free falling through outer space. Heck of a ride, though.
Did you know the rings of Saturn sing?
I saw disembodied arms. Tons of them. They were grasping and crawling.
What about you, Oppy? What did you see?
I saw nothing.
How is that possible? Everybody else saw something.
Must have passed me by. I don't know what to tell you.
But weren't you working in your lab that night?
And weren't you supposed to be doing your research rather than keeping track of my whereabouts?
Okay. Wow. Touchy.
You're asking us to trust you. So yes, it's our business now.
How about this? You two sign off, count orbs, or whatever it is you like to do, and I'll get the driver to the mass hallucination source myself.
Excuse me?
No. Tobias found this remnant. This is his discovery.
Sure. And I'll send you a nice gift basket to mark the occasion. But I won't let anyone interfere with this.
To hell with that! We either throw everything we can at this thing, or we lose this chance, and the answers to the mass hallucination are gone forever!
This isn't like one of your little Sasquatch hunts. I'm not letting you get your tinfoil pseudoscience anywhere near this. This is too damn important to me.
It sure didn't seem too important earlier, when you messed up and nearly killed the driver.
You want to play that game? You really want to talk about our track records?
Screw you, Oppie.
I'd rather run this remnant into the ground than work with either of you.
Oh, forget it. We're wasting our breath with this old bag. There's gotta be another way.
She's out of her mind. I can't do this.
Look, if you want to waste your precious time picking apart bird droppings and squinting at constellations, by all means, follow their lead. But we're better off without them, trust me. I'll get you through no matter what. This really is my last chance.
Thank you.
stabilizers are fully operational. You've got a straight shot toward the expansion wall. One more thing. You may want to consider armoring up a bit. Once you cross that wall, the midzone is another beast altogether.
Thank you. Coverage of limb technology is bright-eyed and bushy-tailed at first. In the decade between 1955 to 1965, limb is called many things. The promise of the future, the herald of a new age, the never spoken of again. You don't have to dig very deep for the gaps in the story to emerge. The presidential demonstration is the only physical proof we ever see of it. Compared to the Manhattan Project, developed under airtight shroud of secrecy, why was limb paraded around in the papers? And if it really was the technological quantum leap to answer all our wildest dreams, why did it blink out of existence? The story of limb technology is one hell of a maze, and the key to it is a woman named Dr. Ophelia Turner. Did Ophelia Turner, by all measure a failed physicist as far as her public record goes, truly invent limb technology? Or was she held up as a Rosie the Riveter for the Cold War? An atomic Annie to excite the masses during the no-holds-barred race against the Soviet Union? Is she a myth, martyr, or monster? A figment of the imagination? True savior? Or convenient scapegoat? I'm Chiaki Saruhashi, and in this 9-part series, I aim to find out.
Thank you.